Hey guys, here I am again in the new year with an ACEO. These are little art cards that fit in baseball card holders. And lots of people really collect them. I have a bunch in a binder somewhere. They're a really great option for when you want to have an original art collection, but you don't really have a whole lot of money to spare, because original art can be kind of expensive. I also started doing some deep sea stuff in my sketchbook, and usually I will use a theme until I get tired of it. So this is gonna be a anglerfish. Anglerfishes kind of freak me out. I didn't really want to do an anglerfish for an ACEO. They are definitely one of the more recognizable deep sea creatures. So I just went with it. I'm just sketching straight from scratch with a pen. I actually started it on the wrong side of the paper, but I just moved it over, and your eye will follow the correct line that you put down. So it's not a big deal if you have a bunch of random lines and mistakes everywhere. You know, don't bother trying to erase them, just go with it. These fish are one of many that are bioluminescent, and so I thought that it would be fun to add silver ink. So when you turn it side to side, you can see the shimmer off of his little fins, all the little lines on his face, little dots rather. In the middle of making this, I was actually sort of absentmindedly picking at my shirt. I was wearing this tank top that has little rhinestones glued to the front of it, and I accidentally pulled off one of the black rhinestones, and so I'm putting it in his eye. I thought it looked really cool to have a bejeweled eye on this fish. The one thing I did struggle though with was the background. I liked the background color that was happening, but it was clashing with the fish itself. The fish turned out to be way more purple than I was expecting, I guess. And so, yeah, the happy, brightly colored background just wasn't working for me. And I really thought that I was ruining it. I thought maybe adding an overlay through a stencil here. I mixed molding paste with black paint to make the molding paste black, because usually acrylic paint, especially craft acrylic paint, is too thin to work through a stencil because it'll just seep under and get everywhere. Yeah, no. To my surprise, the stencil transfer did work, but it still wasn't enough. It was still was clashing too much with the purple. So at first I tried to move the black paint around. I sprayed it, but it was already stuck on. Maybe I let it dry for just a little bit too long. And I tried moving it with the paintbrush, and that was working okay. I can't remember which order it went in, but I did try spraying other types of ink on it to sort of cover it with more appropriate colors that might work. That didn't help. And spreading the black around really made it look muddy and gross. I dripped a bit of gold spray ink on it, which I thought really kind of brought it back together. It looks more undersea to me. It definitely fits the theme of, you know, phosphorescence and bioluminescence and stuff to have this metallic gold mica on the surface of the card. And then I rubbed the edges with a black ink stamp. I think it looks more mysterious now, deep sea, you don't know what's down there. But here's this anglerfish. So here's the finished card, and it will be available in my Etsy shop as soon as this video is uploaded. So I hope you enjoy this video, and I will see you next time.